So I got this new cassette and Freehub combo on a Bafang G62 motor, and it is not freewheeling the way it's supposed to, which is leading to some awkward behavior while riding the bike, with the chain getting loose in ways that it's not supposed to when you backpedal. I'm going to take this off and see if I can lube it and get it to run a bunch smoother. So first, I'm going to take off this lock ring. And for that, we're going to use this little park tool. I'm going to go in here. I'm going to stop the free wheel from moving with this wrench and get it all undone. That should just lift right off. Yay. Now, got some spacer rings here. Remove those, set them aside. Feeling kind of crunchy. So I'm going to take these interior rings off as well. This part I had a little trouble with originally, and what really helped is getting a 10mm to stick around the shaft to stop it from rotating while I use these pliers to get the lock ring unstuck here. Probably a tool that's better for doing this. I do not have it. There we go. Now, on a normal rear wheel installation, this is where you would take the skewer out and then you could get at the free hub and unscrew it. However, since this is a motor, we're gonna actually have to take the motor out. So we're gonna flip the wheel over. And we're gonna get the M4, I believe. We're going to take all these bolts in the motor out. Well, it's not an M4. Not an M4. It's a F3.
may have to take the disc brake rotor off here. Last one here. With that out, I should be able to just push this right up and out. Like so. And that comes right on out. You got your motor, and you can just set that aside. Now this Freehub is different than the typical ones, because in the typical ones there would be a way to stick a Allen wrench in here and remove this and unscrew it. But I believe these are very specific to Bafang, and they use these hex or Phillips screws on the top to put them in and out. So we're going to take those out, and hopefully the Freehub just pops right out through the bottom. This is what one of those little screws looks like. Back to removing the rest. Hopefully that allows us to just remove this. Yep, there we go. Let's just pop that right out. Now I wonder about getting this bearing out. Some oil here in this bit.
Stays like this when I get it all reassembled. Oops. Let's get this put back on. There we go. Got that nice and lined up. Screws back in. Alright. Put that all back on. All screwed into place. We're going to put the motor back on. Nothing too fancy to put the motor back in. One bit of caution, if you turn this upside down, this gear set is likely to slide right off, and it's kind of a pain to get back in, so I recommend actually putting it on through the bottom like this. And you just gotta wiggle it into place. There we go, drops in. Line up the holes, and you're good to start bolting it back together. On. Quick test. It spins just fine. Or I can make it spin with a 10 millimeter by doing this. Boom. Perfect. Alright. Now, on this side, there are three things that go in here. There's this spacer, and then there are two locking nuts. The spacer goes in first. And personally, I like to put the spacer with the softer edge down. Go ahead and squish that in there. There we go. Pushing that past a rubber seal here. Get that in there nice and good. That works. We're going to put on the first one of these washers for nuts. far as I'm getting that one. Let's see how we're spinning. Seems a little better. With that, it's time to put all the gears back on correctly. Oops, there goes the, which means first, spacers we took off earlier. Put these guys back on. Two more, including the lock ring, really. Thread that on by hand to make sure I'm not cross-threading it first. And you can use the tool, get that nice and tight. That is moving much longer than it did previously. Then all I gotta do is put the disc brake back on and put it all back together and see how it does. Let's see how that compares. It is not freewheeling the way it's supposed to. And now there's no more issues backpedaling. Right.